return here on MMA Live. John Anik alongside billionaire fight promoter JJ Riley. The Tap Out crew is here, Punk and Scraper in the building. Now, JJ, what led to this project that is really redefining mixed martial arts here in the States?
Well, mixed martial arts is a sport I've been incredibly passionate about. As far as where the idea for Sparta came from, I've always kind of really dug the Grand Prix format, so I tracked these guys down.
And when JJ came to us, he said he wanted to create the Super Bowl of mixed martial arts.
And he decided to put up the $5 million purse, too.
Well, there you have it. It shall be done. Hedge fund king JJ Riley going from the lion's den of Wall Street to the cage and promoting the biggest winner-take-all tournament in MMA history, Sparta.
Fitzy still owns this?
No, Fitzy. Colt Boyd owns this gym. Can I help you with something?
How does it work?
35 a month with locker. We're open at 7, lights out at 11. So you want to join?
Sure.
Put your name and contact info on the card.
Thank you.
All right, this is less than two, okay? Hold on, Tito. So we have a body rest. You have the bat, which needs...
Acceleration,
okay. If you have enough acceleration, you might have a chance at breaking the body rest. Okay, all right, you ready?
Piece of cake.
Everybody
piece
got
cake,
the glasses on. Okay, go. Piece of cake.
Come on, man! Come on, son!
All right, there we go.
Well done, Tito, yes. Well done.
Remind me not to mess with you. Sit down, everybody. Dial it down. So, have we got it?
Force equals mass times acceleration.
We got it.
All right. Has everybody else got it?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay, good. All right. The third law.
Whoa, how many laws this dude got?
The dude.
Yes, the dude.
The dude has three. All right. Newton the dude says that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. For example, if KC does not stop the action of sending texts in class and tell her posse outside to beat it, then my reaction might be to send it down to Principal Zito's office, thus sending the world back in proper balance.
Mr. C, I put it away.
All right, before you go, I have your test from last week.
Let's work it out. Stop clowning.
Come on,
pick up the hands. Light it up. Seal's hands. Come on. Seal's hands. Keep your hands up. Go light.
Oh.
Said go light.
Girls.
We got a tournament coming up. You gonna kill every guy in the burg? Oh, jeez. Fenroy, give me some ice. And call that Puerto Rican kid, the one that fights out of the bottoms. If he's here in 20 minutes, he gets $200.
You want to fight him?
Do me a favor, guy. Go back to your bag. We don't need anybody else getting hurt. Take a walk. Let's go. Watch his neck.
Yo, Rock. What'd you do? Did you leave Mick and Polly at home today?
Phone's disconnected. Go through the list. Find me somebody. Get me Joe Bones.
All I'm saying is that if you need somebody to help you, I'm happy to keep your boy warm for you.
You ever fought before?
Hey, this guy signed a waiver?
All good.
What's your name?
Tommy.
You get tuned up in here, it's on you, Tom.
Sure, no problem.
Come on in. Let's go.
All right, let's go.
Oh, boy, watch that team.
You gonna be a hero? All right.
Oh, come on. Check that kick. Easy.
This one here. See, this is the new appraisal figures as they came in.
Yeah.
And this is how it affects the monthly, turns into that. And the total value of the loan over the life of the loan is that. As you can see, that's just the way it is. It puts you upside down. That's the problem. It's the county that did the assessment, not the bank. So numbers are what they are, Mr. Conley.
Brandon.
The numbers are what they are, Brandon. I mean, you're a math teacher, right? You can appreciate that.
I'm a physics teacher. I teach physics.
Physics, okay. But well, the bank has got to go by the new appraisal figures. And according to these figures, you're upside down on your mortgage,
yeah,
you understand?
I said that like three times. I'm sorry, but I get that. I'm asking you, is there something else you can do? Not the bank, you. Can you shift things around, restructure?
You refinanced twice already.
Because you advised us to do that. You told
me. Well, I presented you with that option, but that was your choice. I'm also showing that you netted a substantial payout with the refi.
We had that conversation. I was paying medical bills.
Oh, right. Sorry. Your daughter's kidney?
Heart.
Heart. Right. Sorry. A lot of stories.
So that's my option. I have no options. You're not even going to try and help
me.
You're not even going to try.
No, I'm trying. Look, Brendan, I can get you 90 days to get even.
90 days is not enough. My wife and I, we have three jobs between us. That doesn't cut it. So what do you suggest?
Let me ask you a question. Have you thought about bankruptcy? It's a viable option. There's no shame in this these days.
That's not how I do things.
Okay, well then, you're looking at foreclosure.